Welcome. What's your name?
My name's Lauren.
And where are you from?
From Brooklyn, New York.
Is that right?
Yes.
So why Britain's Got Talent?
Most of my favorite singers are from the UK, so I thought I'd come pay a visit to you guys.
Okay, so Lauren, tell me a bit about you.
I think some of you guys have actually heard my voice, but you don't know my face. I sang the song Never Enough on The Greatest Showman.
No. Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Blew their minds!
Oh my God!
So I was hired to do the reference vocals for the actresses so they could learn the songs. And so they had me come in and sing Never Enough. And it really was Rebecca Ferguson, who plays Jenny Lind, who said, I think that Lauren should sing the song, and I'll lip sync.
So you sang one of the biggest songs of all time. You've now revealed it wasn't the actress who sang the song in the movie. It was you singing that song. So why didn't you get that big deal after the song?
I was more comfortable singing behind the scenes, but I feel kind of like the song was meant for me, and I'm kind of ready to put a face to the song. So I'm here to do that.
Are you going to sing that tonight?
Yes.
Such a great thing to watch.
Good luck.
Here we go. Breathe, girl.
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way, can't let this moment end. I set off a dream in me, getting loud and now, can you hear it echoing? Will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough, never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold
never enough.
It's not the recognition we should deserve.
I am absolutely shaking. I can't believe I've had this incredible opportunity to give you your moment to shine, because this is it.
We were just in palm of your hand from like the first note. I can't think there's been many experiences on the show where we've ever had that feeling.
Well, it feels like a superstar's arrived. Like it transcended, it was otherworldly.
This is so well deserved, because seeing somebody else sing that song in that movie and not have the recognition of doing one of the most incredible vocals ever. And now, for you to kind of reveal yourself to the world, it was actually one of the most incredible audition moments I've ever experienced. I'm speechless.
Thank you.
I'm so happy. Timing in life is everything, and maybe this is your moment now. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
The stage is yours, sir. Good luck.
Oh, I love him already.
Come on, Ned.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years.
I want to start a fight.
Savage. It was really fun meeting Ant and Dec backstage, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
Oh, he's killing us all!
Alicia?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Alicia laughing?
Oh, no.
At least you're not dancing.
That was good.
Simon.
Godson!
Who reminds me a lot of my dad. He's a cross-dresser. He gets especially cross when he can't find his socks. For David Williams when he swam on the River Thames for charity because of all that garbage going in his mouth. But since I've been watching BGT, I'm relieved it's all coming out again.
Well done, Ned.
No. What? Did you touch that?
No, I didn't touch it. I don't know what's going on.
Amanda, please follow me up onto the stage. Come and take a seat.
I don't like it.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose. Like the child that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it to teach a lesson in loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theatre's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. You are holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet, Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Joy.
Amanda, I want you to take a deep breath and tell everyone what Alicia is holding in her right hand.
A dummy. No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
What's up? My name is MB14. My real name is Mohamed. I'm 28 and I'm a singer from France.
You're all busy.
Okay. I started singing when I was a teenager. I remember in class we had some choir lessons sometimes. We used to sing. I got into performing when I was in high school. I tried a drama class, and the first time I stepped on that stage, I felt something really special, and I understood that that's where I was supposed to be.
The ultimate dream would be, to perform in the whole world.
And be
a musician.
I'm here because I remember when I was a teenager, I would spend hours and hours and days on YouTube. I used to watch the judges. I've watched a lot of performances, so I really want to convince them that I have my place here, you know, that I deserve to be here. Today means a lot. It's something that I've been waiting for a long time. If I can have like 4 yeses, it would be the perfect scenario. We'll see, finger crossed.
Hello there.
Hey,
how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
My name is MB14. Nice to meet you.
MB14?
Yeah, MB14. Those are my initials and my favorite number.
Ah, okay.
And where are you from?
I'm from France.
Ah, welcome.
Thank you. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Croissant, baguette.
Oh, we like you. We like you a lot. Come on, let's get you on stage.
They're ready.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just care about you. I swear I live.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
Oh, yes. Hello, too. Tell me all about you. I want to know everything.
My name is MB14.
And I'm French.
Oh, c'est très bien. And what made you come to this show in Britain, Britain Got Talent?
The Train, Eurostar. It's been a long time that I've been watching BGT, you know? And I remember when I started watching that show, I felt a lot of inspiration. And I say to myself, maybe one day I'll be on that stage, so.
Well, here you are.
I thought maybe I'll be on the stage one day, but not in the audience.
So, what is your act based on?
Basically, all you're about to hear is made with my voice, so I hope you like it.
Show us what you've got.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
You make me feel like I'm gonna stop.
Well done. Well done. That was brilliant, man. I loved everything about that. You're welcome. You're welcome.
That was amazing. So good.
Take a bow. Take a bow. Take a bow.
Yeah, we like him.
He's great.
He's amazing.
Literally, I was hypnotized by your music. That is the power of music, that it gets you and it makes you want to dance. It makes you happy. You did a fantastic job, Alicia.
You are absolutely phenomenal. We've never had anyone like you on the show.
I agree.
The fact that you've got nice hair, no one cares about that today.
I care.
You are phenomenal, my friend.
It just felt cool, it felt now, we've seen nothing like it. It was fantastic.
I don't know where you've been.
I have been in France.
Seriously, it doesn't matter where you're from, we should have heard of you by now because this was phenomenal. I mean, seriously, phenomenal.
Yes! Yes!
Look at them. They were like greyhounds out of a trap. We didn't even have a chance to say anything. Anyway, it's so well deserved.
Thank you so much.
It's one of the great, great, great auditions you will never, ever forget.
Amazing.
That's
amazing.
No, mercy to you.
This is amazing. Absolutely amazing.
First, I didn't think that they would like it so much. And second, what a surprise you did to me today. I really didn't expect the golden buzzer. It's wow.
Listen, well done.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Very welcome.
Thank you for
You're
your
welcome.
Congratulations. That was amazing.
I'm part of this adventure with you guys.
That's an honor.
Thank you so much.
Please introduce yourselves.
I'm Lexie.
I'm Christopher.
And how old are you guys?
We're both 10.
Okay. And so how did you two meet?
Well, there's a website.
Really?
A website, and if you're both in the same category, then you're a match. So obviously we were a match.
Oh.
So. Christopher, is she the boss in this relationship?
Well, she thinks she is.
So, how long have you been dancing together?
Almost 2 years.
Okay. And what song are you going to dance to today?
Dear Future Husband, because he's my future husband.
Really?
That looks a bit...
He's like, I'm not sure about
he's,
that.
He's doing this. How do you feel about that, Christopher?
Not very happy.
You're not very happy? Why not? What's wrong with Lexie?
She's just annoying.
I know the feeling.
Okay. Well, I think things have got off to a great start. Let's see if you can work out some of these tensions through the medium of dance. The stage is yours, guys. Good luck.
They're very funny.
That's brilliant.
Sing along with me.
Hello.
What are your names?
My name is Billy, and this is my sister Emily.
Ah, fantastic. So how long have you known each other? So Billy and Emily, how old are you guys?
I'm 28 and she's 25.
My name's Billy.
I'm Emily. We're from Birmingham.
We're brother and sister, and we are roller skaters. We started roller skating when we were kids.
I was 5 and my brother was 8. Our mother, she saw on TV some roller skaters, and she thought, oh, that's elegant and safe and something nice that we can do together. So she bought us roller skates, and from that moment on, we were hooked.
I love skating with my sister. I will not skate with anyone else.
He's my big brother, and I've always looked up to him. I'm performing with my best friend. Today, we want to make our parents proud, and we're going to give it our all.
We're going to try and put on a great show, and hopefully the judges and the audience will love it.
Take it away, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
Like, I was so worried for your head. You're fearless and like a fresh spin on roller skating. I thought it was fantastic.
Felt dangerous and fresh. So I congratulate you for being something so exciting to roller skating and to Britain's Got Talent.
And you know, I've seen a lot of roller skating acts on this show. Normally they are horrific because you kind of think, what can you do on a stage with roller skates? I've actually never seen an act like that in my life. I mean, it's incredible. Really incredible.
I'm going to kick this off with a big, fat yes.
Thank you.
A very, very easy yes. Well done.
Massive yes from me.
It's a big, fat yes.
Yeah. Standing ovation from the crowd and all four judges.
It's more than I could ever wish for.
Brilliant. Thank you. Like, it's a dream come true.
Oh, it was brilliant. Good variety act.
What is he going to do?
Hello.
Good evening.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
Good, good. Right, tell us a bit about yourself.
My name is Marc Mitral. I come from Paris.
Bonjour.
So what are you going to do for us today?
I have a special guest for you.
Okay.
Can I invite?
Sure.
Yeah. Just for you, Miss Wendy. Come on. Down here. Sit down. Okay, you can't fall down. Don't worry.
And dog is cute.
Isn't she lovely?
Hello, I am Marc Metral. I am 61 and I come from Paris.
How are you feeling about today?
Well, you know, when you work with a live dog, it's always...
Anything can happen.
Yeah, fragile. I grew up in a little village in France and my parents was peach farmers. It's it was a hard life. If you like fish, I can bring you a good one.
So what kind of dog is Wendy?
It's a Rottweiler. I have this dog since he has 2 months. Without air, I will be nothing. You think about your audition? Is everything gonna be all right, no? Vivian, my wife, she told me you are crazy to make Britain Got Talent. But to play in front of a royal family, for me, it's like a dream. I'm always dreaming, even at my age.
Whenever you're ready.
Hey, you can say good evening. You speak English? It's my night. Come on, hey, say something.
No.
What, why not? It's fantastic, come on. Presency Dutch.
Yes. Oh my God.
No, no, listen, English.
Si.
Spanish.
Oui.
Français.
Okay.
Okay. Hey, Wendy, listen to me. You think I am stupid?
Yes.
This is brilliant! I want one!
So, well, you don't want to speak anymore?
No.
Okay. And now?
Oh, yes, I want.
You know how to sing?
No.
What?
Yes, yes, yes.
Good. Okay. Well, we'll listen to you.
Meow.
It's bow wow, eh? You understand?
Meow. Yeah.
Music, please. We're going to sing something for you, all right? Okay, don't look at me. Look at the audience, like that. Feelings, come on.
Feelings.
Nothing more.
Nothing
more.
More.
Trying to forget. All together, okay?
No.
Please, come on. It's pretty good talent, okay? All together. Feelings.
Aye, aye.
Feeling.
Oh, my God.
What's her name?
Wendy.
Wendy.
Try and listen when they're doing the act.
Well, I'm emotional.
He's waited a long time for this moment. For 9 years, Simon has said he wanted a dog that could meow or sing. And your dog did both those things. I mean, you're making television history here with this.
Wow. I don't know how she does that, how you taught her to do it, but it was incredible.
Oh, thank you so much.
How does she know the words?
She's very clever.
It's an incredible act and one we're never going to forget, Mark. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Fantastic act, Mark. Really something special. Right, David.
Well, this is a very easy yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
You've got four big fat yeses.
Congratulations!
That was fantastic.
That was brilliant. Well done.
Unbelievable. How can you get a dog to do that?
Brilliant, Mark.
Thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you. We found a dog who sang and talked.
Well,
we found a dog that can sing.
No, we haven't.
I love that Simon's telling everyone.
Lauren, are you sitting down?
Yeah.
A dog came in and sang.
Well, it didn't.
Oh, my God. Are you serious?
I swear, and meowed.
Well, you was fantastic.
He is amazing.
The dog can't actually meow.
It's sad.
What song are you going to sing for us today?
I'm going to be singing She's Always a Woman by Billy Joel.
All right, we'll wish you luck.
Thank you very much.
She can kill with a smile, she can wound with her eyes. She can ruin your faith with her casual lies. And she only reveals what she wants you to see. Yeah, she hides like a child, but she's always a woman to me. She just changes her mind. She'll promise you more than the Garden of Eden. Then she'll carelessly cut you and laugh while you're bleeding. But she'll bring out the best and the worst you can be. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me. Changes her mind. She's frequently kind and she's suddenly cruel. She can do as she pleases, she's nobody's fool. And she can't be convicted, she's earned her degree. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Maya Goff.
And how old are you, Maya?
I'm 12 years old.
It's a beautiful dress. I nearly wore that dress today, actually. Lucky I didn't. Whereabouts are you from?
I'm from South Wales.
She seems sweet.
Who's with you today?
I got a lot of family with me today. I've got my mum, my dad, my sister, my auntie, my uncle, my grandma, my grandpa, my cousins. Yeah.
So all of Wales, basically. I guess you're going to sing for us today.
Yes.
So who's your biggest singing idol?
Whitney Houston. I'm singing a Whitney Houston song today, and I just love Whitney Houston.
OK, well, we wish you all the best, Maya.
Thank you.
Colors for you.
that you are and everything that you do. Oh, I don't really need to look very much further. I don't wanna have to go where you don't follow. I won't hold it back again. This passion inside, I can't run from myself. There's no
You ready, yeah?
Yeah, man.
It's all yours.
Good luck.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Oleg. I represent Team Udi tonight.
What's Team Udi?
Team Udi is a dance team.
Are you in Team Udi?
They are my big friends.
So you're not in the group, you're
no,
their friend?
No, just a friend, yeah.
And so you're like their translator?
Something like this, yeah.
And where are they from?
From Siberia, Tomsk.
We are UDI, dance team UDI.
From Tomsk,
Siberia.
Uh-huh. We are UDI, we are from Tomsk, Siberia.
Dance team.
Dancing is our life.
UDI is a big friendly family.
In Siberia, we run own dance school for underprivileged kids. We work closely with the local orphanage to give the children a sense of belonging. This is a matter of great honor for us.
If UDI win the Britain's Got Talent, they want to build a big, big school.
Today means everything to us. If the British public gets behind us, it could change our lives and the children's lives forever.
We want to impress.
We want to impress British peoples and judges. Yes.
Okay, well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you, Alex.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
We always say we're looking for something we've never seen before on Britain's Got Talent, and I've never seen anything like that. Wow.
Oh my goodness. Visually, one of the best things I think I've ever seen. Like, that was absolutely perfect.
I'm almost at a loss for words. It just felt so brilliant.
Sometimes we're asked why we have people from other countries entering, but I'm so happy that we do have that, because then we get to see artists as fantastic as you.
Welcome. A humongous yes.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You've got four big fat guys.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. What's your name?
My name's Shakarudin, but people call me Junior.
Junior.
Yeah.
How old are you, Junior?
I'm 17.
What are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to be dancing.
Okay, so what got you into dance?
Well, in the past, I've had some behavioural issues, and, like, I've been dancing, like, for a long time now,
okay.
And it's really helped me grow as a person and get better, so...
I'm really, really nervous today. This is like the biggest performance I'm ever gonna do. I've come a really long way. Now I have the chance to prove myself and show my family who I am.
I've been waiting for this for a long time, and like I feel like it's a must. I have to do it.
When I was at school, like I used to struggle a lot with the work. I would feel like if I'm getting a bad grade, I can't do better. Like I would just feel like I'm like a dumb kid, or I'm just not smart enough. I felt like misbehaving was like the only option. I used to get in a lot of trouble, got excluded a few times. I was in a bad situation. When I started dancing, it actually gave me like so much confidence, and I got people praising me and saying good things about me rather than being in school and messing about.
But like I've been training every day, man. So like hopefully like it all pays off.
When I am dancing, I feel free. I can just like tell you a story, I can talk to you. Dancing has saved me from going down a completely different road. I can imagine if I wasn't dancing, like, I don't know where I would be today.
Okay, good. The stage is yours.
Thank you.
do you feel right now? Is it overwhelming? Alicia, what did you think?
Do you know what? Usually that kind of thing cringes me out, but for some reason with you, it didn't at all. I couldn't take my eyes off of you. That was incredible.
Thank you.
I could see it in your eyes, what it meant to you, and all the negative things that you've obviously been through, you've now turned into a positive. It was an amazing, very different performance to anything we've seen before.
Thank you.
I have to tell you, it's one of the most incredible things I've ever seen on this show. I mean, seriously. You're going to be talked about after this performance, I'm telling you.
Thank you.
I thought it was so brave of you to channel all your emotions and anger or feelings, whatever they might be, into a piece like that. And it really expands what we think dance can be. So it was incredible what you did. You should be very proud.
Thank you.
We're going to vote. And I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Junior, it's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
And make that four yeses.
Tremendous.
Wow.
Well,
that was amazing.
Well done, come around here.
Well, I thought that was really, like you said, he was very brave.
Yeah, it really meant a lot to him.
Yeah, definitely.
What a brilliant thing.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Jessie J. McParland.
And where are you from?
I'm from Ireland.
Okay. How old are you?
Nine.
Okay, who are you here with?
My daddy.
Okay, Beth.
Yeah.
You excited?
Yeah. I'm here with my dad today, so I am. My mummy is home looking after my two younger sisters. My daddy's very good at doing my hair. He even went to the hairdressers to learn how to do it right. He works as a farmer and it's not really his thing.
Team Daddy and Ginger?
Yeah.
You can grab.
Being the first girl in the family, my mum and dad wanted me to be an Irish dancer.
When did you stop?
When I was three.
6 years ago?
Yeah.
That's a long time.
I would love to impress Simon Cowell because he's the boss of One Direction. I like One Direction because I went to their concert last year, so I did. And I'm very excited for today because I've never performed in front of a big audience and I just love to be cheered on.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
Dinky little thing.
Yeah.
My God. Do you want a job as my security guard?
What made you want to do this?
I used to do ballet and I was dancing.
This is a long way from ballet.
But I didn't like it.
She's cute as hell like that.
Yeah.
As soon as that sword comes out, jump up, up, jump, jump.
Jessica, you are one to watch in this competition. That was incredible. So impressed.
It was brilliant as an act, and I'm sure you're going to be at the Olympics one day doing karate.
Maybe in the next act, two little people could be the villains and you can beat them up.
Yeah.
I think he means us.
OK, moment of truth. David.
I'm going to say yes.
Jessica, it's a massive yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Jessica, 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Good girl.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Well done, Jessica.
Yeah.
That was brilliant.
God, you wouldn't mess with her, would you?
Unbelievable.
Well done.
See you next time.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
So pretty.
Yes, she's special. She's really special.
Hello?
I got 4 yeses.
I can't, oh my God!
You're Callum, Jade's brother. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, well, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
I'm 26, I'm from Hull. And I'm singing a cover of a song by Robin.
I love Robin.
Yeah. It's dancing on my own, but it's a bit slower.
Okay, whenever you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Somebody said you got a new friend. Does she love you better than I can? And there's a big black sky over my town. I know where you're at, I bet she's around. Stilettos and broken bottles, I'm spinning around in circles, and I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm right over here. Why can't you see me? Oh, oh, oh. And I'm giving. Come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here. I just came to say goodbye. I'm in the corner watching you kiss her. Oh, and I'm giving it my all, but I'm not the guy you're taking home. Lights come on, the music dies, but you don't see me standing here.
Thank you so much. Codling.
Hello, Lewis. Where are you from?
I'm a London boy.
London. And how old are you?
I'm 27. I'm just singing for you today.
Oh, you're singing today? Okay, brilliant. Good luck.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, oh, come on.
Oh.
Give me a bit, man. That's funny.
Sorry, Norris.
Actually have me fooled.
Thanks.
Yeah, you're a very good actor. Where do you guys normally perform and gig?
We just literally put the whole show together. I've got a really dry mouth. It's fine.
David wants, do you want to give him some water?
Oh, David.
Don't worry. There we go. No problem. Well done, really good stuff, yeah? Really good. Let me just say, I'm not sure you really want me to take my clothes off, Nick. It's not quite as nice as that.
I think, you know, we're going to have to take a vote before things get out of hand. OK, David, yes or no?
Yeah, I'm sort of on the fence. OK, it's a yes, OK.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me, guys.
Simon?
I'm going to say yes.
Yes.
Come on. Four yeses, please.
And it's a big, fat, juicy yes from me.
Yes!
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you?
We're old men grooving.
Okay. Do you have jobs?
Yes, we do.
I'm an IT manager.
I'm a teacher. And I do some part-time teaching as well.
Do you think that this is something that the Queen or the Royal Family would like?
Yeah, we think they're going to love what we're doing.
OK, best of luck.
Thank you.
Imagine being their kids.
I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, don't ask me.
Classic Britain's Got Talent.
It's my favourite one.
Can I ask a question? What are you going to sing?
No.
We're a dance crew.
What?
We're a dance act.
Is this serious?
No.
Yes, very serious.
Honestly?
Yes.
Okay.
And you think you can win this?
Yeah.
Like to think so.
Show us what you can do. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you very much.
Come on, boy band. Let's lift this roof.
Living it up in the city. Got chucks up the same rock. Got a Christmas up so pretty. I'm too hot.
wish you the best of luck. We can't wait to hear the song now.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Take it on?
Yes!
Come on, let's go.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Hey.
Oh, we're here!
It's crazy. This is crazy. Thank you.
What's your name?
We are Revelation Avenue.
So how long have you guys been performing together?
We've been together since school, really. We were broken up for about 3 years, and now we've decided to come back and take to the stage. This, for us, is the biggest thing that we've done. I mean, we rehearse at my house. So, yeah, to be in here is massive for us.
Do you think that a choir can win this show?
Yes.
We had one of the worst choirs we've ever had earlier on.
We really hope you guys enjoy it, to be honest.
I hope it all goes well. We wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
The boat and make a mess. I said quietly, agreed politely.
Guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, but I fell for everything.
Help me down, but I got up.
Congratulations. Congratulations, Amanda.
You know, what I loved, I think, was the sense of heart and relationship and togetherness. Just magnificent.
It's like you're all stars. You could actually all probably be solo singers, and yet you work perfectly together. It was flawless, guys. Well done.
We had one of the worst choirs we've ever had on this show, and now we've had one of the best. You on the left, your personality when you sing, it's amazing to watch, but you've got this incredible bond amongst all of you. Congratulations.
So happy for you guys. Congratulations.
Straight through to the live
semi-final. You just wanted them to do well. There was something about them, wasn't there? Yeah.
All yours. Have fun out there.
Good luck, Pat.
Good luck.
Good evening.
What's your name?
My name's Christina Lennon.
Christina, why are you here?
I want to be the next Paul McKenna. I'm a comedy stage hypnotist.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? Is that possible?
Can you hypnotise somebody to stop being really annoying?
How long is this going to go on?
Quite a while. OK, well, look, why don't you just get on with the act?
I am actually only one half of the act. I'm the assistant.
Oh, OK, so you're not the person who's actually...
hypnotising, no. I've got the master hypnotiser.
OK.
This is Princess the Hypno Dog. No way.
Hang on. You are telling me that that dog is a hypnotist?
I am indeed.
Hypno Dog?
My name is Christina Lennon, and this is Princess. And today we're going to be hypnotising volunteers from the audience.
This is Princess. She's a girl.
Yes.
Don't look into her eyes. Okay. Don't look into her eyes
we'll
too much.
She's the world's only hypno dog.
What does it involve then? You're
actually... She looks into people's eyes and they just fall asleep.
We've actually had instances that at the wrong moment where she's looked at somebody and they've fallen out of the seat or gone to sleep. So now we tend to keep her out of the way until she's needed. Going to show them something that they've never seen before. The world's only canine hypnotist.
Okay, I've got to see this.
I need some volunteers from the audience. Let's have a look. Yep, you guys there, that row there. Do you want to come take a seat? Couple more seats, guys.
Us two.
Come on, you know you want to.
We're gonna get hypnotized by a dog. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, he's scared, man.
He's scared.
On the count of five, you'll all be wide awake. As soon as I ask you to count, you'll find the number seven does not exist. On the count of five, wide awake. One, two, three, four, and wide awake. Wide awake. Do you want to take a seat back in your places? Do you want to count from 1 to 10 for me, please?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Try.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Okay. Give them a round of applause. Dick, are you up? Will you be quiet about Dick?
8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Alicia.
What the hell is going on? What have you done to our aunt and Dick?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8.
Well, she's amazing, and wow, I think Paul McKenna has got a problem.
Did you believe it, Simon?
Well, I did at the end, yeah. I mean, I think if you're going to do this, I think you've got to get them to do more crazy things.
Yeah, this was more to show you what the dog can do.
Would you do it with to me?
Yes.
Welcome to the stage.
Here we go.
I'd kneel down if I were you.
That's a first for a start.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? Want to be a nice person?
This is the clip they'll use when they know you finally lost your mind.
Well, nothing's happening.
I don't think we can hypnotise everyone.
Just a normal dog.
What happened?
Well, just like a dog with a huge tongue staring at me.
Right, we're going to take a vote, yes or no.
David, yes or no?
I'm intrigued and I'm going to say yes.
I am interested in seeing what else you could possibly do, so I am a little bit on the fence. But I think I'm going to say yes today.
I'm going to say yes. Hello, Simon. Simon?
Yes for me.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done.
Well done.
Are you awake?
I'm yawning.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. You've got to change this.
Yeah.
You're the best. You're the best, and you're the best, David.
That dog's done something to you, 100%.
Hello. What's your name?
My name is Jamie Raven.
Hello, Jamie Raven.
Hello.
How old are you?
I am 31.
And where are you from?
Originally from Hammersmith, but I now live... big up. I now live in Ascot with my wife.
Can I ask you what you're doing today?
I'm a magician. My earliest memory of watching magic was probably about 10 or 11. We were on a family holiday and we were out in a restaurant and I had a magician who came over and he did his act. I thought it was amazing. That was it, and it would spark something that, you know, 20 years later would bring me here today. I live at home with my wife, Ashley. She's the best thing that ever happened to me, and everything I do, everything is for her. When we first met, we were at the bar, and I said, oh, I'll get you a drink. And she had a £5 note, so I folded it up and changed it into a £50 note and paid for it, and it was all the money I had in the world. That was one thing that won her over, the prospect of, yeah, £50 notes. Little did she know that was the only one that she'd see for the next 8 years. Over the years, I've performed in pubs, I've done clubs, I've done the darkest rooms, the loudest rooms. You know, it is a slog. I just want them to see the decades, basically, of practice and what I know I can do. So I'm excited and nervous in myself. I want to do the best that I can do. Today could change everything. To actually do the raw variety as a performer, you made it.
OK.
Good luck.
Go on, mate.
May I come and join you at your table? Would that be okay? I'd like to share with you a trick. It uses a £50 note,
one of the largest currency notes available in this country. With my sleeves rolled up, guys, with nothing in my hands, we can get a shot of this on the screen. I'm going to change this £50 note into the much rarer, infinitely more valuable Bank of Britain's Got Talent £50 note.
No way.
Now you can see we've got our head of state, Mr. Simon Cowell. We've got our beautiful princesses, of course, our queen. Simon, for you to keep. Don't spend it all at once. Guys, I don't want you to feel left out. So I brought along some more cash for you. But I know deep down, you don't really want one of these. You'd much rather have one of those Bank of Britain's Got Talent. One for each of you to keep.
Oh, I love that.
Thank you very much.
What? Thought I'd finish with a trick using a picture that I've drawn. It's a self-portrait. That's me. This is where we are. Britain's Got Talent. You see, most magicians at this point would ask one of you to reach in and take a card. I'm not going to do that. Instead, if I may, I'm just going to ask each of you one question. David, if I may start with you. So if I could ask you to choose a colour, red or black, whatever you say is what we will use. What colour would you like?
Black.
Black. Alicia, the black cards are split into two suits. We have the spades, we have the clubs. Again, if I could ask you to choose, whatever you want is what we will use.
Clubs.
Clubs, fantastic. Amanda, I need you to choose a value for me. What would you like?
Nine.
The nine of clubs. Simon, you're the boss. I'm going to give you the chance, if you like, to stick with the nine of clubs, or you can overrule all of the other judges and you can choose any other card that you like. What would you like?
Seven of hearts.
The seven of hearts. Okay. Guys, there is no way I could know that you would choose the nine of clubs. There's no way I would know if you would overall, and if you would, what you would change to. You'll agree I haven't touched these. What I didn't tell you is that I've also drawn on the back of every single other card in this deck. Do you remember those cartoon flip books where you flick through and the little man comes to life? Check this out. You see our magician. He takes off his hat. He reaches inside. He pulls out just one card, ladies and gentlemen, not just any card, it's the Seven of Hearts.
I know this sounds crazy, but I now actually believe in magic. I do. Like some people believe in ghosts, I now believe in magic because there is no explanation for that.
None whatsoever. Alicia?
Oh, my goodness. Honestly, that is going to bug us for the rest of the day, how you did that. You are incredible. I feel like we are witnessing the beginning of something special with you.
Bless you.
David?
I mean, that is a world-class trick. That's one of the best magic tricks I've ever seen. And
it's not a trick.
It's real magic. Yeah. He has magical powers.
Somebody once said to me, who I really respect, that there are a lot of people who do tricks and there are few people who actually can do magic. And I think we just saw that.
Could you make Simon disappear?
We're going to take a vote. David?
Of course, yes!
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
You've got four yeses. Congratulations.
I now believe.
Come on!
Well done, pal.
How was that?
Well, it's amazing.
Best trick I've seen.